Everybody doing all right? Yeah. I'm going to start off here with a little tune that I learned from Kenny Baker, an old probably Tin Pan Alley song that he took and really made a fine number out of. It's called Sweet Bunch of Daisies.
Thank you for coming back. There's Chris Bresch here with his fiddle. I told you he lives in Amherst, Massachusetts. He's actually from Missouri and grew up in the Missouri fiddling tradition, and he talked about that very nicely in the section of the course that he taught. Ben Fraker did such a good job there a while ago singing that folk song for you folks. Pardon me. This is an old timer from the 1930s. It's pre-bluegrass, and it was featured by one of the great fiddlers on the Grand Ole Opry, a fellow named Fiddlin' Arthur Smith, and he fiddled up a storm, and a lot of his fiddle style was adopted into bluegrass music. Chris has been playing Arthur Smith licks all night long here without anybody even saying it. But Arthur Smith also sang. He was a good singer, he was a good time guy, and he had some good songs, and this is one he recorded with a couple of brothers from Alabama. They sang it too. And Ben does a real good job on it. And I believe, Nick, you're going to help him. Is that right?
All right.
Yes, sir. It's called I'm Gonna. All right now. It's not too late to find another guitar player. It's a number called I'm Gonna Lay Down My Old Guitar.
Well, I wish I could tie it to my side and take it along.
cry for me. I'm gonna lay down my old guitar. Lay down my old guitar. Well, I wish I could tie it to my side and take it along with me. No one to cry for me, no one to cry for me. Well, I've traveled too far from my home, you see. There's no one to cry for me. I'm gonna lay down my old guitar. Lay down my old guitar. Well, I wish I could tie it to my side and take it along with me.
Sing about our instruments. Yes, sir. We would like to do a Vladimir Scruggs number now that was mighty popular for them in the later 1950s on the Grand Ole Opry. This will bring in Nick and Chris to help me sing on it. And it's an unusual kind of a bluegrass number because it's in waltz time, but it doesn't really feel like one you would waltz to. So it's a bit different because of that. Flat Scruggs did this, and it's called "That Was Before I Met You." I thought I had seen pretty girls in my time. That was before I met you. I never saw one that I wanted for mine. That was before I met you. I thought I was swinging the world by the tail. I thought I could never be blue. I thought I'd been kissed and I thought I'd been loved. But that was before I met you. I wanted to ramble and always be free, but that was before I met you. I said no woman could ever hold me, but that was before I met you. I thought I was swinging the world by the tail, thought I could never be blue. I thought I'd been kissed and I thought I'd been loved. That was before I met you. I forgot what I did. They say that I must reap just what I have sown. Darling, I hope it's not true. For once I made plans about living alone, but that was before I met you. I thought I was swinging the world by the tail. I thought I could never be blue. I thought I'd been kissed and I thought I'd been loved, but that was before I met you. Thank you, folks. Thank you very much. We'd like to have Ben Fraker come back with his magic mandolin and play a number that Bill Monroe pieced together from different things he just heard in the air. He heard some things that an African-American blues harmonica player on the Grand Ole Opry played, this real, real bluesy number, and it didn't even have any meter or beat to it or anything. It's just blues, blues, and more blues. And he adapted it to the mandolin. So Ben, come on up and play this number. And he does a mighty fine job, and I'll take this snare banjo over in the corner and keep it quiet for a while. It's a good number to play in a church. It's called Evening Prayer Blues. That blues, nothing but blues right there. But I always like to hear Ben play that. Good to have Chris along to play that too. We'd like to do another song that's older than bluegrass. It dates from about, I think, 1901 or 1902. It's a true story from the newspapers. And it was one of the very first country string band records that was made in the early 1920s. And two fellows made records of basically the same song, the same story. It was current in the state of Virginia. And they worked for two different record companies. And there was a huge lawsuit over who owned the song. And it actually went to federal court. Imagine that, you know, a country string band song. I can't even remember which one won the case, but he got the money from it. But it's a popular song, train song, about the wreck of a great train that ran down through Virginia called the Old 97. So I'd like to sing the wreck of the Old 97. Indeed, right? Gave him his orders up in Monroe, Virginia, saying, Steve, you're way behind time. This is not 38, you're in old 97, put her in dispenser on time. So he turned and said to his black greasy fireman, shovel in a little more coal. And when we cross old White Oak Mountain, you can watch old 97 roll. Rough road from Lynchburg to Danville, lined on a 3-mile grade. It was on that grade that he lost his air brakes. You'll see what a jump he made. They were going down the grade, making 90 miles an hour, when a whistle began to scream. They were found in the wreck with his hand on the throttle, scalded to death by the steam. Then a telegram came up to Washington City, and this is what it said. Oh, the brave engineer who pulled old 97, he's lying in old Danville dead. Now, ladies, you must all take this warning from this time on and learn. Never speak harsh words to your true love or husband. He may leave you and never return. Well, we want to go back to a good Bill Monroe number now. And I mentioned earlier that Bill Monroe was doing pretty good business before Elvis came along, he had a huge hit in 1945. Just before Lester Flatt and Earl Scruggs joined his band, and it was a really big hit, and it started a whole craze in country music of state waltzes. Well, this one's called the Kentucky Waltz, but shortly thereafter was the much more famous Tennessee Waltz. That was a huge country and pop music hit. And then every state had to have, there was a Pennsylvania waltz and an Alabama waltz and a West Virginia waltz and all that. But this is the granddaddy of them all. Bill Monroe said he wrote this traveling from one show to another, driving across Kentucky, and the full moon was up, and it just hit him that he would write this song. So Chris has got the good high tenor pitch voice, and he's gonna fiddle it just like it was fiddled on the record. But like I said, Elvis came along in 1955, 56, and pretty much destroyed country music, and nobody could sell a ticket or sell a record. So Bill Monroe didn't mind too bad, because the first record Elvis made, on the backside of it, had Blue Moon of Kentucky. So Bill said he got powerful royalty checks from that, and he didn't mind a bit. So he re-recorded it, and he started it off the old way, like he did it in 1945, but in kind of a tip of the Stetson hat. He cranked it up a little bit in the second half. a little bit after Elvis. So Chris, if you'll start it off the old way, and if you feel like it, we'll do it Elvis's way. Good at the time. And this is one of his big ones. In 1962, Flat Scruggs played in Carnegie Hall. And amazingly enough, they were not the first bluegrass band in Carnegie Hall. A bar band from Baltimore was the first band in Carnegie Hall. And I never did understand it. But Flat Scruggs went in a couple of years later and made a record album of it that I pretty much grew up on. And this is one of Earl Scruggs' compositions. And Chris and Ben and all the boys really do a nice job following on this. It's called the Flint Hill Special. And it's going to look like I'm untuning my banjo, but they have little special things on them so they don't go wrong. They go to a place and come back. So we hope you like it, the Flint Hill Special. If I can do it right. Stop speeding up. Harder than I thought. Well, we're going to go back to Bill Monroe now. I know you like the picking, and the classes were about the individual instruments, and particularly the fiddle and the mandolin really, I just think, do wonderful things in bluegrass music. And like Bill Monroe said, bluegrass has been really good for the banjo, so I'm thankful for that. But these two fellows have a song that Bill Monroe composed with his ace fiddler, who played with him for, I think, 27 continuous years, another Kentuckian named Kenny Baker. And together, riding endless miles on the bus, they put this tune together. And it's named after the ridge behind the Monroe family home place down there in Rosine, Kentucky. So Chris will lead it off, and Ben will help him out on it. It's called Jerusalem Ridge. That number is called Jerusalem Ridge, and the Monroe farm was on Monroe Ridge, I guess, and Pigeon Ridge, I think. And his brother Charlie owned a house on the next ridge down. It was called Pea Ridge. All like up around here in the Hudson Valley, just ridges that go and go and go and go. 600 acres up in there. Had a coal mine, timber operation, and hay, and 25, 30 employees working the place, but all for naught. Farm broke up. We have a trio we'd like to do again from the Stanley Brothers, Nick's favorite band, and he likes to do this one. So Chris and I will help him sing it a little bit. Stop, that's my song. And so Chris will kick it off, and hope you'll like it a lot. It's called I'll Never Grow Tired of You. Bluegrass numbers. Bill Monroe has called this the Texas Cowboy number, and he really liked this. Chris can really sing it and fiddle it. I hope you will enjoy it. It's about a cowboy and his dead horse, and it's called Goodbye, Old Pal.
Here we go, folks. Thank you.
suddenly.
I don't think you would have done that, but it belonged in the song. You've been a wonderful audience. It's wonderful that you all came out and spent this beautiful Sunday evening with us. We have a couple more tunes we'd like to do for you. This one is one that Bill Monroe used to like to close out his festivals. A couple of familiar gospel songs. The first one is called I Saw the Light, which is the Hank Williams number. And the second one is Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. He really liked those two numbers and would play them as a medley and invite everybody to sing along. So I hope if you know him, you will just rear back and beller like a dying calf in a hailstorm. It's a lot of fun singing the key of B with the Bluegrass Band. So the first one we'll do is I Saw the Light, and I do hope you'll sing in the chorus. One, two, three. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin, and I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Everybody, I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more light. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Like a blind man, I wandered alone. Wearies and fears I claimed for my own. Then like the blind man that God gave back his sight, praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. What did I see? Coming for to carry me home. A band of angels coming for me. Coming for to carry me home. Everybody now, swing low. Coming for to carry me home. Tell all of my friends that I'm coming to. Coming for to carry me home. Last time, swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home.
Thank you.
We have one more instrumental we'd like to play for you. It's a fire breather, and Bill Monroe wrote it in 1949 to show those punks, Flat and Scruggs, and the Stanley Brothers what a real man could do with a mandolin and a bluegrass band. And he used to stomp his feet something awful when he started this one off. So Ben, you come on up and stomp your foot, and we're going to do Bill Monroe's signature mandolin piece called. Are you going to do it, Nick? You're going to join us? Everything okay?
After you do something really fast, I'll see.
I see, okay. This number's called Rawhide. Ben Fraker with the mandolin, Chris Brashear with the fiddle, Nick Novia with the guitar, Dave Gandon with the bass, I'm Dick Bowden with the banjo. You've been wonderful. Thank you. Please support bluegrass music in the HVBS. Hey, Dave. We didn't have Dave play. You play one more? Oh, yeah. Come on. Come on. One. Come on, Dave. Come on. Oh, you got to do it. They want it. This is short and sweet. There's no fireworks except coming off his fingers. And in no time will his fingers leave his hand. What you gonna play, Dave? Go ahead, come on up and say
it. It must be a glutton for punishment. Yeah, we're doing an old number with grandfather's clock. I'm gonna make a racket over here. Professor Dave Gandon.
Thank you, friends. Support the HVBA, bluegrass music. Thank you. Good night.